Yes, indeed. It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones. Kindled will rise. Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh embers.
Hello, Dark Souls fans, and welcome to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, for this here blind playthrough. Now, I realize, of course, that Dark Souls 3 has been released in Japan for 3 weeks, and a bunch of other people got pre-release access, me not being one of them, because, well, I haven't really done Dark Souls stuff before, so no one would have given me any, and that's fair. However, that does mean, do not spoil me. This is a blind playthrough. I don't mind if you give me advice for stuff that I may have missed in an earlier area, although even then, please limit that to vague hints. I don't want you to tell me outright. But otherwise, don't tell me anything. Please feel free to comment and such, but just don't give me any information about what happens that I haven't seen yet. If I've passed it, give me vague hints. That's about it. Don't give me anything too concrete. Just something that I go, oh yeah, I guess I missed something. I will try to be thorough, but Dark Souls games the way they are, that's typically impossible. So, I'll do my best. If I miss something, please let me know in an indirect way. But, ground rules aside, so here's the thing. My character idea has been something that I've actually developed over the course of the last several games, and I actually already have an appearance set up for it, because why not? It took me a while to do it in two. I did it in one without any issue, because it was the first time. And then in 2, it took me 2 hours to get something that more or less looked like Scarlett Johansson, which wasn't exactly what I was going for, but that's what I got. And now I have this, which is the closest I can find to what I wanted originally, and I think looks... Oops. Basically, the idea is someone who looks somewhat young, but really intense. Like, they'll wreck you. They'll wreck you as soon as look at you, but they don't look that threatening to begin with. I like that idea, so that's what I went with. Also, for those curious, the idea behind the build initially was I wanted a build which was, like, combining a bunch of things I wanted to do. So I wanted to do originally, my first build was like a thief build that went with pyromancy and shields and spears and super defensive. And then I decided I wanted to do the exact opposite. So I went for shieldless, but I got the offhand crossbow because Bloodborne came out and I don't have a PlayStation 4, so I couldn't have played it. But it seemed like a cool idea, so I had the offhand crossbow. And then I also went for cleric because I wanted miracles, because I hadn't used any miracle magic, only a bit of sorcery and a lot of pyromancy. And I also wanted to build for the Great Sword of Artorias, the true Great Sword of Artorias, which was okay, got me through Ulysseal, got me through the catacombs, and I never used it again because after I didn't need the divine protection, the weapon set did not work well against the claymore, which is my target weapon. Hopefully I get a claymore pretty soon, and a crossbow, and then a backup longsword. That's the idea in general for weapons. And then, of course, the miracle magic and everything else. I guess there really isn't anything else. Items are just items, and that's all there is. So, start with the cleric. Let's get into the game proper. Of course, once it actually finishes loading. Load times are fine, though. Load times are pretty good, which is fine. Also, just so you know, in fairness, I have actually been a bit spoiled up to the first boss fight in the Cemetery of Ash. And a little bit beyond that. That's about all I know. Everything else is basically totally unknown to me, so I do have a bit of an idea how things are going to go for the next hour or so, and beyond that, I have no clue, which is awesome! That's exactly what I want! I'm actually a little disappointed about the other stuff, but if you saw episode 0 when I did mechanics testing, I was actually looking to see if other people had tested things like rolling input lag and similar issues, and they had not. No one had in fact tested that, which I found particularly troublesome. Or at least mildly annoying. Anyway. One. Sorry about that slight cut. Anyway, back to the game. So, first area is pretty simple. I mean, it's just a bunch of little hollows. I did check this out a little bit during the mechanics test, so I do know about this bit, obviously. I actually played through it. Not with a cleric, mind you. I've actually only played with a... What do I... Oh, yeah. Heal and force. Okay. Which, of course, doesn't actually hurt anyone because it's not Wrath of the Gods, just Force. Or a mid-Force. Alright, one thing I do want to check. Because everything now has these weapon skills, and I don't know what it does. Gentle Prayer, which I don't know what that does. Nope. Not going to tell me what it does. Can only assume it makes things more fa- No. Well, I guess that works. Anyway. And that's why rolling attacks need to work properly. Okay, so I got that set up. Might as well just drink my Ash and Estus flask. Because mana! Mana's a thing! I've actually never played Demon's Souls, but apparently that was a thing there too. As was the general speed of the game, which is nice. Alright, so this area does not seem to be particularly big. Oh hey, it's a bonfire. Now will I crash? Apparently there's people having crashing issues around this part of the game. I am officially not one of them, so yeah. My guess is... See, the thing is I notice a lot of people have crashing issues with 770s. I have a 970. And I think that's why I don't have the crash issues that a lot of other people have. Because I... Ooh, what's this? Oh, Fading Soul. Not a crossbow. I have a 970, which I think was what the game was designed around, or 980s. I don't know why it's screwing up. My guess is that there's something... Some specific thing that works in slightly later hardware that two generations ago doesn't. That they did some trick or something that breaks it on 770s. Because everyone with 770s or the similar ATI card has the problem. I apparently don't. That's good to know. Or at least I don't have it then. And that looks like a giant crystal lizard. Okay, I actually was aware of this. I shouldn't be too disingenuous. Oops. Wow, okay, so, lived up to the title within 5 minutes. I died horribly. Because I forgot which one was my two-handing. This is two-handing. Wow, that one-shotted me. Sheesh. Sure, I could deal with it, but still, wow, that one-shotted me. That is surprising. Okay, well, no big deal. We'll live. Ah, oh, slightly wrong. It's about 10 minutes into the recording. I mean, those enemies there are pretty trivial. That giant crystal lizard thing, not so much. I mean, I suppose I shouldn't really bother because what am I going to be upgrading? What do I need Titanite for? Okay, that's... Ow. Interesting. Well, the spikes don't curse me, at least. Oh, wow. Talk about revenge, because I killed more than my share of crystal lizards in the earlier games. So, yep, getting revenge. Interesting. Tail whip. Okay, so we have tail whip, a roll, a slam, bite attack. I've been made aware that you can actually attack stun monsters in a way similar to the visceral attacks of Bloodborne. I don't really want to risk that right now. Okay, rolling attack. Man, this is tough, but at least rolling attacks work properly, so I don't have to worry too much about roll to avoid problems, and then... Wow, does that get rid of my targeting? Oh, out of stamina. Okay, gotta be careful about that. Make sure I don't lose my stamina, because otherwise that will be... Oh, shoot. Oh, right, I can do this more freely, because it's not Dark Souls... Two. Shoot. Okay, not sure if that is harmful to me outright in the most obvious ways. Ow! Yeah! Mine! Got a Titanite scale, whatever that upgrades. I'm assuming that's the new Titanite shard. Oh, okay, some items too. All right, that's cool. That's really nice. So we have items. We killed that thing. It only took me 2 tries, which I think is pretty good for a blind playthrough. And yes, I will die. Wait, is this a secret? Why would they put a cliff here if there wasn't a secret? I'm curious a little bit if secrets are opened by... action button or by attacking. And it looks like inconclusive because that area is probably not a secret as much as it looked like it might have been. Okay, so back to the bonfire. And that will be that early opening section. So, like I did say, I was a bit spoiled up to the opening of the hub area, but I forgot about that crystal lizard, to be quite honest. Not the reason I died. The reason I died is because I messed up and hit my weapon art attack instead of... or weapon art button. What does this do? I have to test when I get stuff like lightning spear. Oh yeah, that was the other thing about this character. Sunbro. Or sis, as the case may be. But yeah. Warrior Sunlight. That's another part of this character. I have a bit of a weird narcissistic streak where I feel like it's okay. Like, I'd like to help other people out, but I feel like I'm not supposed to ask for help. So I don't expect to ever summon anything the entire playthrough. I'm not sure if I'm going to get myself summoned, if I'm going to put down summon signs, because on the one hand, that's really nice. I mean, if you put down a summon sign, it's... Oops. Ah, not what I wanted. If you put down a summon sign, it, you know, it helps people out and all that. But on the other hand, that does slow down the playthrough. I'm not progressing as much as it would be if I wasn't setting down summon signs everywhere. So I haven't really decided how I want to go about that. But what I do know is that I want to make sure that I don't summon anything. Like, I'm not going to summon anyone. I know it sounds a little bit weird and maybe hypocritical, but... Wow, that's hard to make. Okay. It sounds a bit hypocritical maybe, but yeah. I've just got this weird thing. I feel like I'm not supposed to summon help. Like, I help you, but how do I help you if I need help from someone else? Like, I don't know. It's weird. I got a weird way of thinking about that that's probably entirely wrong. What does this say? Oh, that's the jump tutorial. How do you get up there? Unless that large rock is walkable. That's probably what it is. Because there's a large rock right next to this that I could probably walk on. Or if not, then it's just a matter of very precise timing. Oh, yeah, I can walk in that rock. Okay. Oops. Would help if I actually, you know, hit it at the right time. Aye. So, it's probably one more time than the boss fight. I feel like it might be boring, but... Nope. I don't recall, like, I feel like that's a ring or something. I mean, why would you put something there? For all I know, it's a fading soul, and I've just wasted all my time. I've got a bad feeling that's the case. I mean, seriously, what would it be? I mean, these aren't the same, quite the same team that Dark Souls 2, so I don't know if they troll that badly. Okay, let's see what it is. It is a Titanite shard! Okay, so what's the Titanite scale, then? Let's get into the habit of looking stuff up. So, Titanite scale is... Oh! Reinforces to +4. Oh, I see. So this is probably for boss weapons. So this is probably... This is obviously your normal weapons, Titanite shards. So we're doing the Dark Souls 3 setup of +10 is max from the looks of it. And Titanite scale is apparently boss weapons. So I guess like Demon Titanite... Well, Demon Titanite or Dragon Scales. And... Soul transposed to +4, so that means there's some sort of slab type thing, apparently. Like, large Titanite scale or something like that. That'll probably get that last bit to +5. Which is interesting, because Dark Souls 2 didn't really have, other than slabs, didn't have an upgrade item for the last leg of the upgrade set. For anything but standard weapons, it was all one item type. Now, of course, in... What? Oops, whoa! I... Really should be paying a bit more attention to what's going on in front of me. So, in... Oops, that was supposed to be a jumping attack. Wow, I've got no health. Anyway, as I was saying, with... Okay. As I was saying, in Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 1 had things like white Titanite shards and chunks and green Titanite shards and blue Titanite shards and chunks and red Titanite shards and chunks. Whereas in Dark Souls 2, it was all just either petrified dragon bones or twinkling Titanite or regular Titanite for basically everything. This is a boss fight. This much I know. This is a boss fight. Grab the sword and get my butt kicked, probably. I mean, it's giving me no time to heal. All right, did I actually do any damage? I did! Wow, this is pretty much like what I just did with that crystal lizard. All right, so you are gonna be spear. All right. This is fine. Oh! Okay. That's scary, but I'll survive if it happens twice. Yeah, that's what I want in my Dark Souls combat. Being able to do that sort of thing and get away with it. Okay, so... whoa. Okay, that was where it punishes me. But I, whoops. Okay, well, might as well heal. Whoa! Or not. How the heck? Okay, I gotta talk shop for a second. I'm not sure why, but my frame rate is really getting killed by OBS right now. And OBS is one of the better programs for recording, and it's... I'm going from 60 FPS to somewhere a little below 30, I think. Not sure what's happening. So... that... I'm not trying to make an excuse in that one. It's just really annoying. Like, am I doing something wrong with OBS? Maybe I should set it to a less CPU-intensive profile. Not sure. That's annoying. Alright, so first half of the boss is trivial. Second half of the boss is going to be a pain in the butt. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. Imagine shouldn't be too bad, though. But, of course, I don't get the free hits, which I got last time. Okay. That's... overhead swing and track and attack. I haven't really seen how bad tracking is in this game compared to 2, or compared to 1 and 2, because 2 is pretty extreme. But 1 had basically nothing and it was fine. Whoa. I think I can survive another hit if I'm not. I can survive to the point where I... nope, I can't. Okay, never mind. I was gonna say survive to the point where it goes big. Not sure what to do then. Okay, this frame rate issue is really bugging me. Right, well, we'll just keep going for the next 5 minutes. So I kind of want to keep these as half-hour episodes. Because I'm pretty sure that's a good length. But honestly, I don't know what a good length is going to be. This might have to be longer. Probably have this one a bit shorter, though. So let's think. I do want to check one thing. I am going to probably see... what happens if I do drop? Yeah, I got a bunch of stamina high. Maybe if I drop... I tried dropping it before. It didn't make much difference. But let's drop to medium. Why not? Oh, in that case, turn motion blur off, because... no. Either make it all or nothing, because... the motion blur in this game isn't bad, but... yeah. Hey. Okay, I'm gonna have to play around with OBS a bit. Anyway, let's try this again. Yeah, I apologize for talking shop. I don't really want to bring that up, and hopefully I'll have all the technical problems sorted out by the next... episode or so. Thought I had prepped this properly, but apparently I missed something. Or rather, previewing the stream is a lot less intensive than actually recording. Which is good to know. Oh, I could have... I just dodged that. Without even having to try. I already dodged it. Oh. Oh! Ah! I'm out of range. Also, not vulnerable to being hit. Well, let's go Fume Knight. Okay. And certainly not the hardest boss ever, but certainly one of the harder bosses. But I feel like compared to Asylum Demon, it's considerably trickier. Like, although, then again, you don't have that scary bit at the start where... oh! On the other hand, I get to do that, which, that was weird. I clearly got some sort of stagger off, but I didn't seem to get any kind of visceral attack or anything, because apparently that's a thing. Apparently you get visceral attacks as a thing. All right, cool, so light bonfire. Woo, bonfire lit, okay. What does this do for me? Nothing. It's just a bonfire labeled after the boss. Okay, so on to the big doors, because there's always big doors out of an area. Man, this is the shortest tutorial area ever. Well, maybe not compared to... I am guessing that this is about the same size as Demon Souls. I'm pretty sure it is, roughly. Okay, so boss beat and broken straight sword. I guess about time. Okay, you are gonna get kicked. And then beat. Okay, I'm really glad they brought kick back. Well, probably at some point I'll be able to kick something off an edge. I missed that in Dark Souls 2. Shield break is all well and good, but kicks do shield break, and they knock things off of ledges. Which is always appreciated. So anyway, we'll just get up this hill. Unless there's other things inside. Are there other things inside? There are! Like this guy here. What did I say? Sooner than I thought. Okay. That's pleasant. That is pleasing to me. Good, kick off a cliff into a bottomless pit. There's a certain simple pleasure in that. Kicking somebody off a cliff to a bottomless pit of their death. What are you carrying? Fading soul, because you always do. I feel like there's just a bunch of enemies here that don't really offer much except for cheap fading souls, which don't really offer much since fading souls. Actually, do I have fading souls as a thing? Fading souls, fading souls, fading souls. Where are you? Fading soul. Probably the same as before. Yeah, smattering of souls. Sovereign soul, source of strength. So yeah, this is like 50 souls. These are probably 100 souls, I'm guessing. I'm guessing, based off the values in Dark Souls 2. Fading souls were a total troll item in Dark Souls 2. Whoa! Hello, zombie dog. Goodbye, zombie dog. Off the hill you go, zombie dog. Okay, so... zombie dog gave me a bit of a scare, but... ooh, ember. That must be humanity, since I realized that I'm burning slightly after beating that boss. I'm guessing it works like Demon Souls, where you beat the boss and you immediately become human. Yeah. No one kindled can ever truly claim the embers that burn within a champion's bosom, which is precisely what makes their yearning for warmth so keen. Gain the strength of flame and an increased max HP until death. With the strength of fire, the summoning signs of unkindled become visible, and seekers of embers can be summoned to join in cooperation. But beware, the embers may also attract invaders. Not sure if I'm going to read all the descriptions, but that one just seemed too poetic not to read. So yeah, it's humanity, and apparently you gain it after beating a boss, like you do, apparently, in Demon Souls. Man, I know there's a lot of stuff that's taken from Demon Souls. I never played Demon Souls. No PlayStation 3. I don't really have consoles. I have a Wii. I have had a couple Nintendo consoles, and that's been about it. Wasn't really allowed to have consoles as a kid. I was only allowed... my first console was a GameCube, and even that was... not entirely under protest, but still kind of, like, my parents weren't totally keen on the idea. That's probably the next area. Oh yeah, also, Firelink Shrine! Yeah, I know, I was spoiled that one, so I'm sorry. That is definitely a thing I was spoiled on, is that the hub Nexus area is Firelink Shrine. Good old classic Firelink Shrine, except it looks much more built up than it used to back in Dark Souls 1 and Lesson 4. Of course, this is in the past, which... something I've heard is a possible theory. I don't know, but I do know that it is Firelink Shrine, and it is a hub area. And I think this is a good place to leave off the episode. Firelink Shrine, with no arch tree in sight. Although, one thing I do want to look for is in Demon's Souls, the Nexus had a big sword at the top. This does not seem to. It has fireflies or something, or... it does. I think what are the thrones I see here, the centerpiece, that's actually the relevant, important thing. So, that's it for this episode. Thank you for joining me in dying horribly, even though I think I only did so like 3 or 4 times. and there will be more episodes soon. So hope you enjoy this, and thanks for watching.